class. You've been over that engine so many times, maybe we ought to build you a seat you can ride there during the race.
Funny, Falcon. With everything that's been happening around here lately, I don't want to take any chances.
Well, you're the boss. Have you seen Rachel?
She went to the motorhome. I think her stomach's upset.
Race day jitters. She used to get them even before we got married.
Great Spirit, please take care of Brian and watch over him. And if he should win, that wouldn't be so bad either.
Boys, look what we got here. Well, it's, hey, it's Pocahontas. Come here, darling. Come here, darling. Where do you think you're going?
Let her go.
Oh, yeah, and you're going to make me Kemosabe?
Yeah. Kemosabe was what Tonto called the Lone Ranger, you big moron. And yeah, I'm going to make you.
Big shot.
Get out of here. Thanks, Walker. What was that all about?
Three races left to go. We're running neck to neck with Team Forbes for the overall championship.
There's still a lot of folks who aren't too happy about us Cherokee whooping up on them out on the track.
Is that right? Well, at least you didn't scalp them.
Maybe we should have.
Attention, all teams. Please man your post position.
All right, Brian. It's time to saddle up.
Brian, be careful, please.
I'll be better than careful. I'll be good. Thanks again, Walker.
Good luck.
Radio contact from Mars. Check that score.
Everybody ready?
This is the time to show those Redskins we mean business, Wade.
Yes, sir, Mr. Forbes. You have nothing to worry about.
Nothing to worry about? Is that what you just said? Huh?
Yes, sir.
The last two times out, those Cherokee beat us. They made us look like fools, boy. Now, if that don't worry you, maybe I need to find myself another driver. Is that what I need to do, Wade? Huh?
No, sir.
Good. Now you get out there and you kick a little Redskin butt. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now you fix up that Cherokee car just like we said.
Unsuspecting stranger had better know the truth of wrong from right. Cause the eyes of the ranger are upon you. Any wrong you do, he's gonna see. When you're
in Texas, look behind you.
'Cause that's where the Rangers gonna be.
Check it out. Brian's starting in the second post position.
Yeah, he had the second best qualifying time.
0.03 of a second behind Coltrane.
Didn't Coltrane win the overall title last year?
Yeah, he did. If it wasn't for Brian, he'd be favored again.
Yeah, if Brian wins, we're going to use the money to build a new school on the reservation and large clinic. It'll be good.
With only three races left, the sensational team Cherokee will make history by winning the National Cup in only their first year on the circuit. Be sure they are making a lot of our heads to drive hotter than the car out there. No one's leaving the heat more than two times. Snap of the M-Rain Coltrane in car number 17. Take a gander at the front row, folks. Brian Falcon in car number 14. How about this rookie Cherokee? Huh? Went far off the pole position today and three checkered flags in their last five races. Yeah.
Okay, Brian, bring it in. Change the tires, finish up strong.
You got it, Red Pop.
What's going on?
It's the tires, Red Cloud. They've been slashed. Put me down. I'll finish all the rubber I got.
Forget it, Brian. It's
too dangerous.
Put me down, damn
it. Looks like trouble in the Team Cherokee pit.
What is it?
Looks like there's something wrong with the new tires.
They're not changing them.
All trains get back out on the curb and car number 14 still have better tires.
Put me down!
Put him down!
Push! Push! Go! Go! Go!
They didn't change the tires. They didn't change the tires.
I know.
Boy, that delay in the pit really caught Brian Falcon. He's all the way back to this place. Beat that ship! I'm taking the food. Find my car to the food. Find some of my next bronco. Charlie's on the outside. Half jumping the number 40 car up.
Okay, Brian, good. Don't worry about those last cars. It's just Coltrane now.
Now you need to tuck in behind him. Draft off him, save your tires.
You got it, Red Cloud.
Brian, how do we keep the ride with Coltrane while Jones and Peter settle down for third? Come on, Wayne! Get him off your tail!
Yeah, you want to tell me how to do that, Junior?
Okay, Brian.
You're doing great. We're gonna have to pick our time. We only got one shot.
That's all I'm gonna need.
We got 1 minute to go, folks. This port sure ain't gonna fade a hot. Time's running out for Brian Falcon. If he's gonna make a move, he better do it now.
Okay, go!
I'll be right there. Guys, I gotta go. New case. I'll see you all at CD's for the celebration tonight.
Okay.
Woo!
the idea of finishing a race on bad tires? You not only risk your own neck, but you risk the neck of every driver out on that track. What's wrong with you?
There's any place for this, Bosco. You and your boys just get out of here.
Oh, yeah? Well, why don't you just make it? Chief!
All right, that's it. That's enough. We're hanging up now. I disqualify both teams.
Jimmy!
Listen up, kiddos. The smell of victory is in the air. Yes, it is. Put your personality into decorating this place. And let's make these people really feel like they're wanted. And we appreciate them, okay? One president said one time, to the victor belongs the spoils. To these victors, they're going to get some chili. Hey. You can't have that mutt here.
What am I supposed to do? Leave him out at the curb?
Are you a ventriloquist?
Sure, give him all the credit.
Get that damn dog out of here, will you? Cornell, Alex, y'all come on in. Red Cloud, Brian, Carlos, come right in, folks. We prepared the fatted calf.
Oh, this is great.
Oh, my goodness, one thing I forgot to ask. Hate to ask, but... do you have a reservation?
It's all right. We already got one.
You are watching history being made today, folks. 4 out of 6 wins. The papers are calling us unprecedented.
Hey, Joe. We get that school open, you might even learn how to spell unprecedented.
How funny. Very funny.
Cornell, where's Trent?
New case. He'll be here in a little while. CD, what's with the dog?
Well, go ask him yourself. He's a ventriloquist.
The dog?
Hell no, the man.
Can you help, Mr. Malloy? Can you help me find my baby? Find Tracy?
I'm not sure, Mrs. Wright. You say the police are already involved.
Yes, but it's been 5 days since she was reported missing, and they haven't found a thing. Tracy's lost in their red tape, and I'm not saying it's their fault, but she's just a small fish in an awful big pond.
Is it possible that she could have left on her own?
No, Tracy didn't leave on her own. She was taken, and she's in trouble, and I can feel it. She's in bad trouble. Please, Mr. Malloy, please help me find my baby.
I'll do what I can, Mrs. Wright.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I'm not guaranteeing anything, ma'am.
But you'll try.
Yes, ma'am, I'll try.
Cloud, Ryan.
Hey, Washam.
What's up, Walker?
At the race the other day, the slashed tires. What's going on?
We're winning, Walker. That's what's going on.
That doesn't answer my question, Brian.
Washoe's right, Brian. If those tires would have blown during the race, you could have been killed.
Racing is dangerous. Just like wearing a badge.
Any idea who slashed the tires?
I've got my suspicions, Washoe. The only guy that's still at war with the Indians, Freddie Forbes of Team Forbes.
Anything else happen?
Stolen tools, bad fuel. There's even been a few threats against Brian's life.
You never told me any of this.
You got enough to worry about, Rachel.
How could you risk your life this way? And how dare you to keep it from me?
I'm a race car driver. It's not just what I do. It's what I am. And stuff like this comes with the territory, Rach.
No, stuff like this, it doesn't come with any territory. Besides which, you don't have the right to go out there and get yourself killed. Not anymore.
What do you mean?
I hate this, is what I mean. I hate being afraid for you all the time and for us all the time.
I don't get it. She never hated racing before. She was always behind me, 100%.
You better go talk to her.
Yeah, maybe I better.
Hey, thank you, dear.
Have you seen this girl?
Yeah, sure, I recognize her. She used to walk by here after school, usually in a group. Last week, she was alone. Sweet-looking little girl.
Yeah, her mother's very concerned.
So you're checking out her daily route?
Yeah.
Check out this guy over here. Name's Carney. This missing little girl of yours used to give him money, sometimes a quarter, 50 cents. He'd give her one of them paper flowers he makes.
Thanks.
Excuse me, sir.
Sir? Do you know this girl?
Yeah, I know her.
When was the last time you saw her?
The day they took her.
Who took her?
The bat took her. It's a big black thing.
What do you mean, a big black thing?
You know, big black thing.
You mean like some kind of car?
No, bigger than that.
A van? Was it a van?
Yeah, that's it. That's what it was. It was a van with bat on the back.
Bat? You mean on the license plate?
Yeah, on the license plate. It said bat.
Were there any numbers with it?
Yeah, with some numbers. I can't remember
the
numbers.
That's okay, Carney. What else did you see?
Well, the bat van pulled up, and when it drove away, little Tracy, she's a nice little girl, she was gone. Just like that, gone.
Did you mention any of this to the police?
I tried to. But when I told them about the bat, they don't want to talk to me anymore.
Can I buy one of those from you?
Yeah.
Thanks, Carney. You've been a great help.
Yeah. Mister, when you find little Tracy, will you give her this rose for me?
You bet.
Yeah, Carlos, it's Trent. I need your help.
I took her away.
And a bowl for me, and a draft and a glass for my buddy Todd.
How'd I know you're old enough to drink?
I'm 5, Parker, old boy, which in dog years is 35, which is way past the age of consent, like you. So don't sweat it and start pouring. I'm thirsty enough to suck the dew off a cactus.
Well, you better be careful, little fellow, the way you talk to a guy that's older and bigger than you are.
Oh, yeah? Come on. Put up your dukes. Take your best shot. I'll murder you. Remember, I'm half pit bull and half retriever. I'll rip off your leg and bring it back to you. I've had a bad day, CD. I went to the vet. Went in a stud, came out a dud. I guess you and I got a lot in common.
Yeah, what's that?
We both been fixed.
Didn't go well, huh?
That's the understatement of the year. She's crying. Why do they always gotta start crying?
It's one of the great mysteries. Here's another one. We gotta find out a way to get more horsepower.
Have you tried changing the jets?
You know that might work.
Where'd you learn that, Walker?
I used to race, and I couldn't afford a mechanic.
You used to race?
Yeah, a long time ago. Remember the last time you and I raced against each other?
Those were fun times, Washo.
Yeah, they sure were.
Brian, don't worry about Rachel. You and her have been a part of each other for a long time. It'll be okay.
I'll see you guys at the race.
Okay, thanks, Walker. Hey, Joe.
Sorry about Rachel, Brian.
Ah, hell. Old Red Cloud said it's gonna be all right. Can't believe your crew chief. Who can you believe?
Let's pull that carburetor off of here.
Talk about low rent.
You're not kidding.
Afternoon, boys. Anything special you're looking for?
Yeah. Her.
Sorry I can't help you. Cute little piece, though. Is that your van out there? So what if it is, cop?
The little girl's name is Tracy Wright. She was last seen getting into that van.
I don't have to tell you nothing. I got rights.
Yeah? This 12-year-old girl has rights too, dirtbag. Now, where is she?
Hey, pretty boy. Let him go before I come over there and rearrange your face.
Why don't you stay out of it? It's none of your business.
Well, why don't we just make it our business?
Get out of here! Yeah.
now you've put us in a very bad mood.
If you don't start talking, you're about to see how bad it can get.
4267 Humboldt, that's all I'm saying. 4267 Humboldt.
You grabbed it, didn't you?
4267.
Give me your name!
Who paid you to deliver a young girl?
4267 Humboldt.
You're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. Your right to an attorney.
I'm tired of playing games with these Indians.
Well, just what do you want us to do, Mr. Forbes?
I want them out of the race. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Consider it done, Mr. Forbes.
I'll consider it done when it's done. Now go do it.
Yes, sir.
So is Team Cherokee ready for next week's big race?
I sure hope so. And I think they got a good chance of winning, too. If
there are no more accidents.
Yeah.
This is it.
All right. I'll take the front.
Got it.
Detective Sandoval, I'm a police officer. Everything's gonna be all right. You wanna come with me, sweetheart? On their way.
That's the way I found her, wandering the streets. I took her in to help her.
Yeah, you helped her, all right. Get up, you scumbag. Ow!
Said a word. She just cries until they come in here. They give her a shot and then she sleeps. But when she's awake, she just cries. She just cries. And not a word. Not a single word.
Sorry, Mrs. Wright.
Well, we got the examining physician's report. No physical evidence of sexual contact or abuse.
Thank God for that.
But we have a problem.
Burnett is sticking with his story that he found Tracy wandering the streets, he took her home to call for help, and you guys busted in.
That's a bunch of crap, Alex.
I know. But forensics was all over that house, and they came up empty. Without hard evidence, Burnett is probably going to walk.
But what about his little photography studio? The cameras, the lights?
None of that stuff is illegal.
Yeah, but taking pornographic pictures of children is.
I know. But without the pictures, we don't have a case.
Then we'll have to find them. Come on, Carlos.
Well, well, boys. Looks like you've got something to be pleased about. What you got for me?
Well, now, you do want to stop Brian Falcon and this Team Cherokee, right, Mr. Ford?
We got the tool to do it. What kind of tool are we talking about?
The inside kind. Hey, Joe. Joe, come on over here.
Mr. Iron Horse here is number two man on Team Cherokee.
Is that a fact? And what can you do for us?
I can make sure Brian doesn't win the race. How's that?
And why would you do that?
Because I should be driving that car.
And how much is that gonna cost me?
$20,000. 10 up front, and 10 when Brian Falcon loses the race.
Well, you got yourself a deal, Mr. Iron Horse.
Hell, if you can't trust greed, what can you trust?
Pay the man the money, Junior.
Sheriff, those pictures are here.
They're here. I know they are.
Geez, Brian, where you been?
It's Rachel. She won't talk to me. Except for saying she wants me out of racing. It's all she says, over and over again.
What am I gonna do?
Brian, if you can't go out there and focus on the race, then I don't want you out there at all.
Don't worry, Rick. Once I get in the car, I'll be focused.
Nothing up there but spiders.
Same down here. Man, I have checked everywhere, not a thing. Every drawer, every...
Carlos.
What?
Is that where you'd put the couch if you wanted to watch TV?
Nope. The TV.
Bingo!
Come on.
Not to make you sick.
I didn't give him a bad enough beating.
Too.
Water's 200. Oil's 220. Everything's running A-OK.
Looking good, Brian. Hold it steady and keep an eye on Coltrane.
Hey, Junior. Babbitt's car is spraying brake fluid all over the place out here.
You better contact his crew.
Yeah, sure, Wade.
Hold it down a bit, Brian. Save your car for the end of the race.
You got it, Red Fox.
I said slow it down, Brian.
I can't. It's my brakes. They're gone. Said I'm gonna be fine.
This time, Ryan.
Rachel, I know this is hard on you. But racing is my life.
What about me? What am I?
You're my life, too. Please don't do this to me. Please don't make me have to choose.
I can't take this anymore, Ryan.
Why do you all of a sudden want me to give up the only thing I ever wanted to do?
It's not just about you and me anymore, Brian. I'm pregnant.
We're gonna have a baby. That's terrific, honey.
So, Brian, you could have been killed out there today. Do you want our child to grow up without a father?
That'll never happen, Rachel.
You just don't get it, do you?
I'll go talk to her.
Hey, Brian.
How you feeling?
Oh, all right, I guess.
Good.
Guess what, guys? I'm gonna be a daddy.
Hey! Congratulations.
What are we gonna do, Red Cloud?
I don't know. If we use every cent of our winnings, we can get a new car. But without a driver...
But you still have a driver.
That leg of yours isn't gonna heal in time. We're just gonna have to wait and try again next year.
I'm not talking about me. I'm talking about Walker.
What do you say, Walker?
Hey, hey, wait a minute, Brian. It's been a long time since I've raced a car.
I know. But this is our last chance, Walker. It took every dime we could raise on the reservation to get this thing going. If we don't win this year, there won't be a next year. Am I right?
He's right, Marshall.
You know what they say? It's just like riding a bike.
Yeah, right. You never forget.
Don't look at me, buddy.
Well, what the heck? Let's give it a go, I guess.
All right! Yeah.
Okay. When's the last time you raced a car?
You don't want to know.
Rachel, what's wrong?
Nothing. Oh, everything. I'm pregnant.
You're gonna have a baby? That's wonderful.
No, it's not. I mean, yes, it is. Alex, I've always been supportive of Brian's racing. But now... Brian has to make a choice, racing or us.
Rachel, believe me, I understand exactly how you're feeling. But there's one thing that you need to remember. The man you fell in love with, the man you married, is an impassioned race car driver. It's such a part of who he is. If you push this ultimatum, he's gonna choose you. But then, who are you in love with?
And this is another win for the Forbes racing team, putting them on top of the overall standings. Now for a report on Brian Falcon. Mild concussion, minor burns, and a broken leg, but otherwise okay.
And by golly, that is good news.
Sure is, CD.
Hey, and who are you, might I ask?
I'm Thoughts. Who are you?
I'm C.D. Parker, and I own this place.
You must be so proud. Now, why don't you stop asking questions and start pouring? I'm dry as kindling.
You know, I thought I hated that dog. Speaking of kindling, I could use some toothpicks in here.
Is that so?
Yeah.
Come on, shake hands. You'll get a slither.
Bring the dog next time.
Stock Car Racing Federation checks out with flying colors.
What about Freddie Forbes?
He's racked up a hell of a resume. Goes back to his dirt track days. We're talking sanctions, rules violations, fired crew members.
I'd be willing to bet it goes deeper than that.
So you think Forbes had something to do with Brian's accident?
Yeah, I do.
Well, if Forbes is behind the accident, then we're talking attempted murder.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've got the evidence and we're on our way.
I'll clear my schedule. Good work.
Thanks.
These pictures have put Burnett away for good.
No, buddy. We make a pretty good team.
Yeah, we do.
Sure you won't reconsider this whole gun thing and just join the force?
Yeah, I'm sure. And besides, I kind of like being my own boss. Nobody to...
Hang on. Got a damsel in distress up here. Look.
You know, Carlos, I really hate to be politically correct and all, but it's actually kind of sexist.
What do you mean sexist? That's not sexist.
Well, it's as if the only reason you want to stop is because she's a pretty lady.
Oh, it's not the only reason. It's... That's the main reason, but it's not the only reason.
Hello! Oh, thank you for stopping.
My pleasure.
That seems to be the problem.
Well, I don't know. I was just driving down the road, and everything was fine, and I just lost power.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
If I were to refer to you as a damsel in distress, I mean, would you think that was a sexist comment?
Damsel. Well, I guess that depends.
On what?
Are you going to be my white knight?
Oh, brother. I don't know. Everything looks fine.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, hey! Hey! Hey!
Not only did they steal my car, but the evidence against Burnett was under the seat.
You know, the Metroplex has been hit by a rash of car thefts in the last few months. Trivette, run it up on the computer, will you?
I've heard about these thefts. You think Trent's car was stolen by the same guys?
It's a possibility.
These boys are pros. They target high-end and classic cars, most of which are worth their weight in gold in Asia, Middle East, and South America. I'm looking at four fatalities directly connected to the crew in the past 6 weeks. The guys that got stealing the cars are good, too. Professional caliber drivers.
Yeah, well, all I know is that I gotta find my car and get those negatives.
We've got 48 hours to do it, otherwise Burnett walks.
We're not gonna let that happen.
Easy, Burnett, easy.
You gotta get the bail lowered, Howard. Then get me out of here.
Look, buddy, you're just gonna have to stay cool because there isn't any way that bail's gonna get lowered. The DA's got a weak case and knows it. That's why they're holding you over with high bail.
Howard, some of the guys in here have heard what I do to kids. Now get me out of here.
Mel, relax. The police have got nothing, not even the testimony of that girl. You're gonna walk the prelim. I guarantee it. Chin up, Mel, chin up.
Worked up a sketch, we've been through the books, and so far we've come up with zip. What else can we do?
She touched me.
Yeah.
Great, come on, Carlos, think. Oh, she touched me, right here. I'm good.
You got a print?
Oh, yeah. Just call her Titanic, because this baby's going down. Lois DiNardo.
She's done bits for credit card fraud, bad checks, and theft by deception.
Some damsel. Let's do it.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Cal.
Team Cherokee out of the running, that cup is ours for the taking.
Oh, yeah.
Damn, they got a new car already?
What?
Yeah, but who's the driver? It's the Ranger.
That's what it looks like.
Good, Watson. Real good.
It feels fine.
I think I'll kick it up a few notches. Easy, Washo.
Well, now's the time to see if I can do it.
Back in business, boys.
So much for that.
Yeah.
Are you looking for Lois?
Yes, ma'am. You know where we might find her?
Are you police officers?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh. Are you gonna arrest her?
No, we just want to talk to her.
Try Elm Street Bar. It's down in Deep Ellum.
Thanks.
I think you should arrest her.
For what?
Look at the house. Look at it. Look at it. I mean, it's gone down something awful. If that's not a crime, I don't know what is.
I hear you.
Well, I'm glad somebody does.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
This business is getting out of hand.
And that thing with the vet the other day, what was
that? Oh, come on, Barnes. I mean, that's a challenge. Yeah, that's the stuff that makes us fun.
Yeah, right, fun. We got four dead bodies tied to this.
This looks positively charming.
Look, Barnes, it's real simple. If you can't stand the heat, then get out of the kitchen.
That's good advice.
I'm sorry, do I know you?
Sure you do. You're White Knight.
I'm the guy whose car you stole. These guys bothering you, Lois?
Yeah. You know, as a matter of fact, they are, Jojo. If you would get rid of them, I'd be very grateful.
Let's get out of here.
What do you want?
I want Team Cherokee finished, once and for all.
I did my part. I fixed the brakes and Falcon's out of commission. I didn't expect him to bring in Walker.
I don't give a damn what you expect or didn't expect. We're going to pay you the money we still owe you. But you're going to have to do one more little thing. Lee and Sims will give you a hand. And if you back down, you're a dead man. Stand.
All right, guys, listen up.
Right.
Yeah, they busted Barnes and Lois. We move everything. First thing in the morning.
Right.
Get cracking.
Right. You got it, man.
How's it going?
I've been at it all night. Lois won't give me a thing.
What about Barnes?
Same with him.
Okay. If they want to play games, we'll play a game of our own.
Call it heads. Tails. Okay, I get Lois, you get Barnes.
You got it. All right, and same deal as last time, right?
Mm-hmm. Whoever talks first gets the deal.
Second place takes the fall.
Yep.
Right, same bet as last time?
Yep. $100, I get Lois to talk first.
You got it. And Barnes, you heard the play. You think she's got your back? She's giving you up right now.
She's not saying a thing, man.
She wouldn't do 10 minutes for you. You're gonna do 10 years for her.
I'll be out of here in an hour.
You are dumber than you look, aren't you?
You let Barnes do all the talking? You gonna keep quiet?
Look, I told you guys before, I am not saying anything. So you can give it up, all right?
Guess what? I win. Lois wants to talk.
Hey, no, wait a minute. You don't win, he wins. I just said I wanted to talk, didn't I? Didn't I say that? Tell him. Besides, I know way more than she knows. She's just a girlfriend. I'm the thief.
Did he really want to talk?
Oh, yeah.
Dang. Call.
Got the evidence.
What in tarnation happened to you?
I told you some of the other prisoners found out I was in here for child pornography. They nearly killed me. Next time they will.
There ain't gonna be a next time, Al. We got 10 minutes for your prelims.
Now let's go over what you're gonna see. What's this about?
Hey, listen, you can't come in here. Attorney-client, privilege, lousy.
I know. I feel terrible about it, but you're gonna love this, Devlin. New evidence. You and your client might want to go over this.
I'm dead.
My Lord. Where'd this come from?
His house. Hidden in the back of the television. See in court, counsel.
By the way, Devlin, no plea bargain. Alex Cahill's prosecuting this one.
Don't worry, Mrs. Wright. He's gone for good.
I don't know how to thank you, Mr. Malloy.
Huh? Oh, Tracy, honey. I'm here.
I want to go home.
Tracy, this is one of the men who rescued you. This is Trent Malloy.
Hi.
Hi, Tracy. I have something for you. A friend of yours asked me to give you this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I better get going.
Thank you, Tall Bear. Why didn't you call and let me know you were getting out? I mean, I've been home all day.
You look beautiful. Rachel, being laid up in the hospital has given me a lot of time to think. And if you want me to quit racing, I will.
Well, I don't want you to quit.
You don't?
No, I don't.
What changed your mind?
Come on, sit down. Alex and I talked, and she reminded me of some things that being pregnant made me forget.
Like what?
Like, it's better for everyone involved if your best friend and your lover is happy at what they do. And you could quit racing, you could work for my dad, but you'd hate it. And that hate would poison something in us. And even if we survived as husband and wife, it'd be a dark way to live.
You know I love you very much.
And I love you.
Well, tomorrow's the big day. How do you feel?
I'm too tired to be tired.
You got a right to be pushed. You put in a good month's worth of work in just a few days.
I hope it's enough.
Basho, the Great Spirit wants us to win. We'll win. And if he doesn't, then there's a reason for that.
I guess you're right.
I know I am.
See you in the morning.
Engine hoist. Let me show you how to destroy an engine.
We've got 4 hours before the race. Big Cloud, you performed a miracle by getting me to drive this car. What do you say we perform another one by getting it ready?
What do you say, Team Cherokee? Yeah. You think we can do it?
Well, you heard Washo. Let's get to work.
I got no time to mess with the lights of you.
Give me a big quarter, will you, Big Cloud?
Gave us a carburetor.
I gotta get this car into overdrive. Put the pedal to the metal, boy. Man alive. I'm racing the clock. My baby needs a few repairs.
compliments AER racing team.
Now we're cooking.
Here we go, boys. Have a sandwich.
Oh, you're the best.
Got no time, gotta get this thing in gear.
So they said if the car's not on the track in 5 minutes, we're disqualified.
We're just about ready.
I'm gonna get you.
How'd they do that?
Doesn't matter. They may have put it back together, but they ain't winning with it.
Welcome to Texas Motor Speedway, ladies and gentlemen, in our Dallas 500, the final race in this Cup Series.
Just get out in front and stay there.
And what an exciting season it's been, folks, with Team Ford and rookie Team Cherokee trading the overall point lead all the way down the wire. But each of them needs a win today to take home the Cup Championship.
Take your time. Be patient. Work your way through the field. Remember, it's a long race.
You got it.
Please be careful.
Aren't I always? I'll see you after the race.
Okay.
He's gonna be all right.
Time to last lap.
and rookie driver Cornell Walker.
Started out in 1600, Gene Cherokee has fought his way into the top five.
Wait, you got Cherokee coming up. Now you got Cherokee coming up. Watch.
I see it.
The leader, Sam, is through.
Watch, Coltrane comes in, you come in too. Kane's too tired, give you a splash of gas.
How bad is it, Washo?
It's in the red.
It looks like it will be a two-man, two-lap race all the way.
Hello, Cornell!
You gotta pick it up. Come on, let's go. Pick it up.
He's right on me, man.
Attempted murder, sir.
I'm gonna stand up here.